This is part 52 of jQuery tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to create a simple floating div using jQuery. Here is what we want to achieve. We have a page here with two sections. This is the main content section, and this is the side panel content section. Within the side panel content section, we have this little text side panel content and a div element. Since we've got a lot of text within the main content section, to read all of it, we will have to scroll down. And notice what is going to happen to this div element as we scroll down. Look at that div element, it is always visible. So this div is called a floating div. Let's see how to create this floating div element using jQuery. Let's flip to the presentation. The first step here is to design a page that looks like this. So we want a table with two TDs. So let's create a table element, and this table is going to have a single tr, and this is going to have two TDs. So I'm going to set the width of the first TD, which is going to be our main content section, and I'm going to have another TD, and this will be our side panel content, and the width of this TD is going to be 100 pixels, 150. So this will be side panel, and this will be our main content section. Alright, and here within the side panel TD, let's also include two break elements and then a div element. So this will be our floating div. Let's give it an ID. Let's call this div floating. Okay, and I'm also going to set style attribute. So basically, we want the background color of this div element to be silver, and we want the height to be 150 pixels and width to be 150 pixels. And let's include this little text within that floating div. Let's call this floating div. All right, so let's save the changes. Let's go ahead and reload our HTML1 page. So we've got two TDs here, but we don't have a border. So that's the reason why we can't see it. And also notice the table is aligned on the left. We want that to be aligned center in the vendor. So what I'm going to do is set, first of all, align attribute. Set that to center. And we want border, so I'm going to set border attribute. And we want the border as 1. Okay, so let's go ahead and reload this page. Now look at this, we got the border, the table is aligned in the center, but we have a double border here, so let's go ahead and collapse that border. So to collapse that border, I'm going to use the style attribute and set border collapse property to collapse. Okay, so let's reload this. All right. Now we want this content to be, you know, the content both within the main content section and the side panel content section to be vertically aligned in the top. So what I'm going to do is, in for both of these TDs, I'm going to set vertical align property to top. Let's do that for this TD as well. All right. Okay, so let's save the changes. Let's go ahead and reload this page, and look at that. So now we have the content vertically aligned on the top. All right, at the moment, notice we don't have a scroll bar because we don't have enough content. And in the interest of time, I have already typed the required content. So let's copy that from this notepad and paste it within this main content TD. Save the changes, reload this page, and look at this now. We've got the scroll bar. And look at what's going to happen to this div element as we scroll down. Notice that it becomes visible. It's not floating now, right? Now let's see how to keep this div element floating. So back in Visual Studio, within our jQuery ready function, let's actually minimize this TD. So this is the main content TD that contains all our main content. And within the second TD, we have our div element, which has got this ID div floating. So within our jQuery ready function, I'm going to create a variable. Let's call this floating div. And I'm going to find this div element by ID. So let's use the jQuery ID selector, find that div element. Okay? I'm going to create another variable. Let's call this floating div position. and I'm going to get that using the position function. So what is this position function going to do? It's actually going to return an object, and that object is going to contain two properties, top and left. The top property is going to give us the div's top position. Okay? Now, when we scroll down, we want to execute some code, right? So first we want to capture the scroll event. So $window.scroll. So when the scroll event is raised, we want to handle that and execute some code, which is going to be part of this anonymous function. So when the scroll event is raised, as we scroll, scroll event is raised, and we are going to handle that. Now what we want to do is, we want to get, as we scroll, we want to get the scroll bar current vertical position. Okay, so to get the scroll bar current vertical position, let's actually create a variable. Let's call this scroll bar position. So to get the scroll bar current vertical position, I'm going to use scroll top function. So window dot scroll top. So this is going to give us the scroll bar current top vertical position, right? Now, let's do a check. If scroll bar position, if that is greater than or equal to the floating div position object's top property. So what does this mean? This means if the scroll bar's current vertical position is greater than or equal to the div element's top position, then we want to keep our div element floating. Right? Because that's when it starts to become invisible. Okay? So, to make the div element floating, what I'm going to do is set two CSS properties on this div element. So, this variable refers to the div element. So, let's use that variable. Floating div. I'm going to use CSS function and set two properties. So, I'm going to use a JSON object. So, the first property I'm going to set is position. I'm going to set this to fixed. In a bit I'll explain what that means. And I'm also going to set top. And I'm going to set that to 5 pixels. Okay? Else, I'm going to do the same thing, but this time the position is going to be relative and top is going to be 0 pixels. That's all there to it. So let's save the changes. Let's reload our HTML page 1 and look at this. As we scroll down, look at what is going to happen. Look at that. Our div element is now floating. So what's happening? So the thing that is keeping it floating is this style property, position fixed. And look at this, this top, we have set it to 5 pixels. Now look at this, as we scroll down, between the top of the window and this div element, there is 5 pixels gap, right? So what does it do when we set position to fixed? It is actually creating a fixed position element. So what do we mean by a fixed position element? A fixed position element is positioned relative to the browser window. So this div element is positioned relative to this browser window. Okay? So when we set top to 5 pixels, look at that, you know, between the browser window's top, between the browser window and this div element's top, there is 5 pixels gap. Right? Now, what do you think is going to happen if I set this to 100? So let's reload this page and look at this. As I scroll down, there is going to be 100 pixels in a width or gap between the browser window and the div element. And that will happen when the scroll bar vertical position is greater than or equal to the div's top position. Look at that. As we scroll down, look at what's going to happen. There is now 100 pixels gap. Now we can also set left property. So let's go ahead and set left here. Again, this left will be relative to the browser window. Let me go ahead and set left also to 100. Let's do the same thing here. And let's set left to 0. So let's save the changes. Let's reload this page. Look at this. As I scroll down, you know, from the browser window to this development between them, there will be 100 pixels gap. And similarly, you know, from the browser window, from, you know, on the left hand side, you know, between this div and the browser window, there will be 100 pixels gap. Look at this. As I scroll down, look at that, the div element is right here. So here and here, there is 100 pixels gap. So that's what happens when you set position property to fixed. And look at what is going to happen now. As we scroll up, it comes back to its position, okay, where it belongs. So what's going on here? So it's coming back here because of the code that we have in the else part. So what are we doing in the else part? In the else part, you know, we are setting top and left, and we are setting position to relative. So what does that do? It's actually creating here a relative position element. So what is meant by a relative position element? A relative position element is positioned relative to itself. So the top and left is relative to the same element, you know, where it's positioned. So look at this. As we reload the page, so that's the position of that div element. Okay? Now, in the else part, we are saying position is relative, top is going to be 0, and left is going to be 0. Means, as we scroll down and up, look at this, as we scroll down, it's going to go here because we have set position to fixed, top 100, left 100. That's why it comes here. Now, as we scroll up, when it executes this piece of code, it's going to say position is relative. Since it's relative to itself, you know, and we have set top to 0, left to 0, it's going to come back to where it belonged initially. Okay. On the other hand, let's go ahead and do this. Let me actually set top to maybe 50 and left to 50. Okay. So now let's reload this page. Look at that. This is the original position of the div element. Now, as I scroll down, you know, what is going to happen? Now, when will this code be executed? As long as the scroll bar position is greater than or equal to the top position of the div element. So initially, you know, it will come to this else part where we are saying position is relative, top to 50 and left to 50. So as we start to scroll, this div element will be pushed, you know, 50 pixels from here. Okay? And similarly 50 pixels from the top, you know, from currently where the div element is. Look at this. As I scroll, look at that. There's 50 pixels from the left and 50 pixels from the top. Okay? And, you know, look at this. As it executes the code that is present in the if part, you know, there's 100 pixels on the top and 100 pixels on the left. Okay? So, if you understand what, you know, when we set position to fixed and when we set position to relative, what happens, then this example is very easy to understand. And here is the HTML and jQuery code that we have just written. Thank you for listening and have a great day.